It's another night for the red carpet, and we're here to see Alannah Hill, one of the many shows here at the region, and of course it's Fashion Week. We're going to top up on what's been going on. Security being very strict for backstage, but we'll get behind there. Exclusive little look at the models backstage and a top up of what's been going on the whole week. Strutting your stuff down the catwalk, out of all the labels you've been wearing, what's your favourite?
I don't think I could pick one favourite because I like too many and I don't think it's fair to pick one.
I knew you were going to do that.
Well, it's not, and it's true. I love so many labels and everyone's got such a different style. But I'm lucky I get to wear all of them.
You are?
Yeah.
Now, your career sort of started. Were you shocked how it started?
I was shocked at the way and the speed that it took off because I didn't expect it to. And, you know, people say, oh, you know, things happen over. This literally did happen overnight.
Here you were watching them all up there, and then all of a sudden someone said, you've got to go to Europe, girl, and you did.
No, I didn't.
No?
No, I did a commercial in Sydney for Italy, and then I went to Europe.
But it's the Europe that made you.
Italy.
Yeah.
Yes, I got a credit in Italy.
You pick up yourself a nice boy as well while you're down there.
Yes.
Yeah.
Well, that took quite a few years, but I mean, you know, had I not done the commercial, had I not gone there, I wouldn't have met him. So that's
where do you want to go from here?
Destiny. Where do I want to go?
Yeah. Do you want to take this further, or how do you use this for your advantage?
I think it's not a matter of using it. It's just going with the flow, really. This type of job is very unpredictable. You never know where it's going to go. I get so many offers, so I'm content to let the wave ride the wave.
Well, enjoy.
She does.
For exactly what she does.
Handle me with her. I'm sentimental. And tickle pink. Admit to my spitting image. A permanent fixture. You should see yourself the way I see you. You should see yourself the way I see you. You should see yourself the way I see you. You should see yourself the way I see you. Handle me with care.
Are you going to get sick of being Megan Gale's boyfriend now, or do you want to be yourself?
Nah, that's okay. You know, there is. I think that is for her the best time, so you have to be patient.
But she has your own career going on too, don't you?
Yeah. Very, very high. Yeah, I'm so happy for her, so that's okay.
Well, they compliment each other.
Yes.
So you were down here, you did the Grand Prix, and you won. How did that feel?
Great. Really, really great. Yeah. I enjoy all week.
You've been practicing, or
yeah. But that's a beautiful event. Not only because for the race, but also because I meet very, very beautiful people, and I'm so happy for them.
So you, being Italian, obviously into fast cars.
Yeah.
Fast women.
No.
Really? What's that about?
Hey, I know this type. You know, I'm a little bit. I'm not the Italian type of guy, you know. I'm
a not a real Italian.
Yeah?
I don't believe it.
I'm real Italian man at this point, no.
Oh, you're disappointing me. David Jones now.
there's no other store like.
There is no other store. But they're changing the whole image of the
way
it used to be.
Well, I've been with them for 5 years.
Yeah, but how do you feel with everybody else creeping in?
Happy.
Happy?
Yeah. Well, there's no other Morrissey like Morrissey.
No, there isn't. There's only one original.
So
how's it feel to have Megan Gale in one of your dresses?
Pretty good.
Is that a hard thing to do?
No.
What do you think she looked like? Hot or what?
She always looks hot.
Doesn't
she?
She's
beautiful. She's all woman.
Tottie Goldsmith. Sorry, that's because I'm bumping on your breast there. What's going on? How have you enjoyed today?
Tonight. Megan Gale is such a spunk. She is the epitome of the perfect woman. I'm telling you, all these girls walking down the catwalk, and then there's Megan, yeah. And she's got the legs, the cellulite, the ass, the woman, the body, the whole thing.
Why are you walking down there?
Exactly.
What's going on?
Well, you ask everyone else what's going on.
Excuse me, do we know who this
Why
is?
Why wasn't I walking Why down the catwalk?
Yeah, hello.
What's going on?
Shall we just get you on now?
Should we have a drink?
I think you've had...
I'll leave it till later.
Yeah, there's going to be a whole week of
drinks. I just think it's fantastic. And my favourites was obviously Morrissey, the last evening thing. Collette Dinnigan stuff, except for the blue off the shoulder 70s shit. And my death before dishonor.
Yeah, it's all a bit that now at the moment, isn't it?
It is death the before whole, dishonor. Yeah. And I like Rapid. Death before dishonor because I've just been so screwed over by a guy.
Again?
Haven't we all?
Men, don't you hate them?
Death before dishonor is my motto.
Screw them all, so I reckon.
Keep your legs closed and your options open.
Out what the juice is.
Oh.
What's going on? I'm almost having an affair here.
He's about to make a... Well.
No. He's asking me to leave Richard and marry him.
Oh, that's right.
What a proposal. It's a scoop.
Well, she could get her dresses made for nothing.
Oh, that's true. You'd never look bad. You'd look fantastic 24/7.
Or already got the hair under control.
Yeah.
So what more do you... Oh, the jewellery.
I've got that.
Oh, you got the
are you going to turn it down or are you going
to
accept?
No, we're going to have a very big announcement to make.
Announcement
of two.
Live on the show. And the announcement is they're having an affair. Lilian's having an affair.
Having an affair with David Medwin.
Only the best dressmaker in the world. I'll let these lovebirds to themselves, shall we? You know. Isn't it bliss seeing love in front of the camera?
Yeah.
In the raw.
That's right.
Well, let's not go there.
Hey, back in the limo and it's a hard job, but basically we go off to another fashion show and I think it's the Kylie fashion show at Maya. Basically she's got her lovely lingerie and get to see some sexy shows.
Thank you. in the world, and we had a very successful launch into London just recently. But yeah, I think that fashion is there. You can walk down the street and choose to be any person that you want to be. You can buy that on the high street, so we wanted to reflect that.
Kylie, you've had just such an amazing year. Congratulations, you've had number one selling hits. You've had, of course, as we now know, best selling Love Kylie in London. You've had Grammy nominations, you've had MTV Awards. Do you ever get time just to sit around in your undies?
From day one, and I'm not too proud to say that the range initially we had a few little bumps and little hiccups, but I truly believe unless you do something, you're never going to know how to improve it or how to make it what you want. So a little bit of trial and error in the beginning, and now 2 years later, and as I say, it's a strange product that I'm so proud to be. Here today, launching again.
All about fashion, sweetie, fashion. What do you think of Alannah Hill label?
Yeah, very pretty. Very pretty.
What do you think of the show? Renowned for their dances.
Oh, I haven't seen the show.
Haven't seen the show?
The show's a bit jazzy though, I hear.
Yeah, they are. We're going to have to cross over to one of the shows. Alannah Hill, here we come. Lovely.
Sing my song of love. Tell her how I'm waiting. I'll never see you near the day.
And I'm from Holland, and I've been modelling since 4 years. I'm here tonight for Alannah Hill and ready to wear one, I think. And yeah, I've been travelling around a little bit, and I will stay in Australia for a while.
Hi, I'm Kate Peck, and I'm just getting my toenails painted for the Alannah Hill show. This is just a pre sort of warm up for what we've got in store next. So yeah, it's going to take these things a while to dry, but I'll have to wait. Nothing else I can do.
Talking about how I look like Olivia Newton-John Sandy from Grease Lightning. Do you agree? My hair do, not me. Do you agree?
Yeah, they normally give you healthy stuff, and I'm like, oh my god, fish and chips, so they want me to
just need to eat and clean your teeth
and brush your hair,
shower once every month 2 months. And maybe shave your armpits, but that's not a necessary. So, yeah.
Wants to see your armpits.
No. This is...
No. It's a once a month. So
yeah.
You're done.
It's once a month.
But models don't shave their legs and don't clean their toenails,
as you can see.
See?
Now, every year, Melbourne's Fashion Week starts off with a few celebrities, and basically we've got a Heath Ledger down here. And he's supporting Shem, who's his best friend down from Perth. And this is the first time Shem's actually done the actual official catwalk down at the region. So it's got a very strong anti-war theme. As we all know, basically Heath was protesting in the anti-war rally here in Melbourne. So we'll cross over to Shem and check out some of the fashions on the Melbourne runway. And off to a very fashionable party here. Now, you're no stranger to parties.
No, no stranger.
What's the tip to keep up?
No stranger.
No stranger.
Stranger. Not here.
No. How do you not get drunk? If you go to all these events, you water down the wine. That'd be a tip.
Yeah, no, you just have to really, it's the top ups. That's the danger. Don't go the top up. Don't let them top you up. Because the only way to keep on top of it, so to speak, is to know how many glasses you've had.
What's your limit? One glass.
Well, probably for an event, I could probably get up to about 3 without being ridiculous. But if you just got your hand, because they're very sneaky, you'll be chatting to someone, you've got your hand out, and they'll just go top, 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 and look around and you think. And after the second glass, you don't know whether you've drunk it or not, so I keep it off.
So mark that glass. Well, we're off to the party. It's actually a new party for a model launch, model actors launch, and we'll check that out and see if we can schmooze. And see who's there. You get that, important.
It's one fabulous party after another. The limousine ride was fantastic. I've just got Katie sitting in the car because we're here for a new launch of a new modelling agency, or a renaming of a modelling agency, full of actors, models, all that sort of stuff, and it ties in beautifully with Fashion Week. So we'll just check out what this launch is all about.
I can't begin to tell you actually how nerve-wracking this is. I mean, I've made a number of speeches over the years myself, and I've been on stage once or twice. But I got to tell you, standing up in front of 70 actors is just about as scary as it gets. Of bold.
It's like being in a room on audition for Big Brother. Come in, Peter. Now, you've launched this new agency's name called Bold.
Bold.
It's a very bold thing to do.
It was a very bold thing to do.
Why did you start an agency? Well, buy an old agency, start a new agency.
Well, for me, I mean, I used to be an actor, and I worked in that business in London until the late 1980s, and then since I came to Australia in 1990, I've worked on the business side of the world. And
but you got out of it for a while.
Yeah, I've been out of it.
You didn't learn your lesson. You thought, no, I'm going to get back into it.
Well, I'm back in it on the business side because I feel I can marry the two things together, sort of affinity with artists and what they're going through with some business skills.
Is this a way maybe to get acting jobs yourself? Because now you can cast yourself. I just know the right person for you. It's me.
No.
I'm on to you.
Been there, done that, but I'd much rather be pushing a whole load of other people and making my own 10%. You can call me Mr. 10% than doing anything else.
So. You made a bit of a promise out here to make everybody quite rich.
Rich and famous, absolutely.
That's a good motto, because if they're rich, you're rich.
If they're all rich, I'm a lot richer than all of them.
Think of an agency like Bold then. How do you know what the right agency is for you? Is it a hard thing?
No, yes, but I
I've had two agents before, one with their head up their ass, the other with their head in the clouds. I walked in, I went, DG, that's a really dodgy name. Met Peter and went, nice to see someone coming from it with a business sense, who's done acting, who's done business, who knows both. He's amazing.
I'm Mark from Princess Highway, and right now we're running just a little bit late. We're about to tape some gorgeous shoes and make them all posh so the girls don't walk over, fall over and trip themselves quite embarrassingly. And also there's a bit of a dual action for the fact that these shoes have to go back to the supplier in mint condition even though they have been walked in. So we basically got to just make sure that we can rip the tape off and they're ready to sell again.
The models acting really cool, running down the catwalk, pretty suave. I notice you've improved over the years.
Thank you. Did you enjoy it?
I did enjoy it. I noticed the catwalk was a lot smaller. Is that tricky?
We were talking about that earlier. It was a lot narrower, so we had to be a little more careful.
I think it's because the models are a bit more narrow these days too. You know?
We all had to dive before the show.
Lots of speed and coke and all that sort of stuff, yeah.
Okay, we're not going to go into that. I don't know what you're talking about.
Sorry, what? What's that powder there? Hang on a minute, sorry. That's not bad stuff, actually. Okay, out of the label.
Crazy.
What's your favourite label?
Simona, definitely.
Simona?
Something about the leopard skin pants. It's like,
mine.
What was
Sassenbide.
Yours? Sassenbide, yeah.
A lot of great Sassenbide rugs.